until heaven moves, she will pray. Recently, I was reading about a woman of God called Etta, Madam Etta. She entered into one village they called the Devil's Den. And no evangelist has succeeded in breaking the demons in that land. God took a woman there to do 3 days crusade. Woman of God. She got the first day, nobody attended the crusade. Second day, nobody attended. Third day, it started raining. The woman stood on the pulpit and with a finger, he said, in the name of Jesus, the Son of the living God, who has sent me to this city, yes, and destroyed all the demon powers that have taken siege over the minds of these people. This crusade is going to touch lives. Rain stopped, people threw from their homes as if they were literally driving them to the crusade ground. Woman of God, listen, who said you can accomplish it? There is a vision God has given to you. And I came to tell you, arise. Tell them, arise. Say, arise. And listen, people, on your way to the recovery, understand that you meet people who are equally in pain.
Hey.
You meet people who are equally in pain. Sometimes you can even label them as enemies. This was a man at the point of dying. And David, all his purpose was to recover. If David had ignored that vulnerable man,
yes,
whom his master has left at the point of dying, if David hadn't given him food, David wouldn't have received direction.
Hey.
He wouldn't have known which direction.
True,
because in your way of recovery, you will come to a crossroad. You are going to need one whom you have helped. Sometimes he can be your enemy, but if you can forget about it, I want you to understand that is when God showed David that is the way to go. David came to a crossroad. And maybe some of you are at that point right now. And it is painful to help and support someone who has hurt you in the past.
Hey!
Do you know what? God said to tell you, it is time to let it go. Let it go. Don't let the past cloud your future. Do not let your past hurt, your past pain, your past criticism. Do not let it cloud where you are going. Yes, you were hurt yesterday, but I want you to understand, bring it at the table. Bring it and lay it all at the feet. Say, Master, I come before you. I lay it all down. Why? Because I don't want to trade my future for past head.
Hey!
I don't want to sell my future short for things I've been through in the past. I let it go. Relationships that have hurt me so bad and take my heart. Friends and loved ones, people I supported along the way who turned their backs on me, let it go. Parents, let it go. It's your time of recovery. Tell anybody it's my time. Tell anybody it's my time. Say, joy is coming. Come see the morning. Say, joy is coming in the morning. Say, joy is coming in the morning. Hallelujah. Come on, lift your voice, lift your hands and worship him. Hallelujah. Let the past go. Support even people who have held you back some way, disappointed you, hurt you along the way. God said, listen, I have a great future for you. You can't settle for pain instead of going for joy. You can't settle for the past instead of grabbing hold of the future. Lift up your eyes now and look. Lift up your eyes now. Lift your voice, women. Lift your voice, women. God wants to hear your voice. Say, I want to be like Mary. Lift your voice. Say, Lord, I want to be stay at your feet. I want to have that one important thing. A woman with a true revelation can turn a city around. A woman with a true insight, a true revelation. I remember the woman from John's Gospel, chapter number 4. Ha. She turned the whole city around. If you can but get in touch with Jesus, I'm telling you, you go about touching lives. You go about touching lives. Say, this is my day. Say, this is my day. Say, I am a woman of influence. I am a woman of the presence. When I show up and manifest God's presence, say, and that is what I need to recover. That is what I need to recover. Say, in the mighty name of Jesus, I shake off the past. I don't have time for hate. I don't have time for bitterness. I don't have time for rivalry. But hey, I'm coming out. I'm coming out of any emotional upset, heartbreak, disappointment, and shame. I look into the future. I look at what God is about to do with me. People will hear and say, hey, I look what God has done. Look what God has done. A year or two ago, I remember he told me her story. She told me her story. But after that conference, oh, God encouraged her. Like David encouraged himself in the Lord and said, yes, no more. What am I doing? If I stay here in pain, it's not going to bring recovery. If I stay here sorrowing, if I stay here mourning and mourning, it's not going to change anything. I'm going to stand up because this is my time. It is my time. It's my time. It's my time. It's my time.